Leidos has completed the delivery of Seahawk vessel to the US Navy. Seahawk is a long-range, high-availability, autonomous surface vessel with a composite trimaran hull. This medium-displacement, unmanned surface vehicle, MDUSV, will enhance capabilities for naval operations. Like Leidos's MDUSV Sea Hunter, Seahawk is substantially larger than other U.S. Navy USVs and is much more capable in terms of range, seakeeping, and payload capacity. It's to be noted that the Office of Naval Research awarded Leidos the cost plus fixed fee contract to build the vessel, with an approximate value of $35.5 million in December 2017. As per the company, work was principally carried out on the Mississippi Gulf Coast. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how the U.S. Navy could use autonomously operating Seahawk medium-displacement unmanned surface vehicle to build a ghost fleet. Let's get into the details. This video is sponsored by War Thunder. If you are, like us, fascinated by military vehicles and technology, I recommend you give War Thunder a try. It's a military vehicle combat game which you can download and play for free on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. It has a huge variety of more than 1,200 playable aircraft, tanks, helicopters, and ships from the 1930s to the 1990s, which you can take to battle on land, in the air, and at sea on more than 80 theaters of war. War Thunder's been kind enough to offer all Defense Updates viewers a special bonus, which will grant you a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time for registering using our link in the description below. So take the plunge and join more than 20 million players from around the world. Seahawk is built as a successor of Sea Hunter. Sometime back, U.S. Navy's Sea Hunter project had achieved something special. Sea Hunter, which is an MDUSV, has become the first craft to ever sail from San Diego, California, to Pearl Harbor, Hawaii, and back without needing any onboard crew. Viewers may note that the round trip is almost 5,200 miles, or 8,368 kilometers. On January 31, 2019, Leidos, the lead defense contractor for the Sea Hunter project, announced this achievement in a press release. Gary Fasano, Leidos Defense Group President, had said in the press release, "The Sea Hunter program is leading the world in unmanned, fully autonomous naval ship design and production. The recent long-range mission is the first of its kind and demonstrates to the U.S. Navy that autonomy technology is ready to move from the developmental and experimental stages to advanced mission testing." Viewers may note that Leidos is a Fortune 500 science and technology leader. As per Leidos, Seahawk is designed to operate with little human involvement, thus providing a forward-deployed and rapid-response asset in the global maritime surveillance network. Dan Brinsenhofer, Leidos Vice President for Maritime Solutions, said, "We didn't just put an autonomous navigation system into an existing ship. Every mechanical and electrical system on Seahawk has unique configurations designed to run for months at a time without maintenance or a crew." The trimaran's displacement, when fully loaded, is 145 long tons. This includes 14,000 gallons of fuel that can power the twin diesel engines for a substantial length of time. The company has stated that the Seahawk's upgraded design follows an evaluation of over 300 lessons learned from Sea Hunter. These upgrades were based on joint evaluations by Leidos and the Navy and include upgraded electrical systems, a payload mounting system, and test operator control station. U.S. Navy envisions a ghost fleet consisting of large unmanned surface vehicles, medium unmanned surface vehicles, and extra-large unmanned undersea vehicles. U.S. Navy is still charting out long-term plans on how ghost fleet could be deployed in the future, and there are a lot of possible use cases. Here are some of them. 1. Scout. Ghost Fleet could potentially gather lots of intelligence regarding threats like enemy warships, sea mines, submarines, as well as land-based assets. This will greatly increase situational awareness and help in making tactical decisions. Since they're much cheaper to operate and need no crew, these can be deployed extensively. Ghost Fleet could travel ahead of US Navy's carrier strike groups looking for various types of threats. 2. Decoy. Large warships like cruisers, destroyers, and aircraft carriers can be targeted by high-speed boats, missile-firing fast attack craft, small submarines, sea mines, and land and air-launched anti-ship missiles. Ghost Fleet could be used as decoys that could shield the more valuable assets. They could emit signals, making them look like a proper warship and divert the enemy's focus. Also, they can be used to act as a shield in case of eventuality where the vessels could come in between a warship and enemy's missile and torpedoes. 3. Electronic warfare. The unmanned vessels could be equipped with electronic warfare suites. These systems could be used to jam enemy radars and sensors. They could work in conjunction with other platforms to overwhelm adversaries with electronic warfare, giving American forces a major advantage in battle. 4. Weapons carrier. Ghost Fleet will be used to augment the firepower of the US carrier strike groups. Weapons in Ghost Fleet could be cued by different sensors to strike enemy assets. Rivals are deploying asymmetric means to counter US Navy. This includes deploying A2AD, anti-access area denial, comprising of long-range layer anti-ship missile and air defense systems. It's paramount that US Navy detects and counter these threats without the main assets like supercarriers getting exposed. This is where Ghost Fleet will be crucial, as it can form a protective as well as potentially an offensive layer in the future. The platform has enormous potential, and as AI matures, autonomously working crafts like Seahawk will be able to undertake more complex missions. This remains to be seen how things pan out. It's likely to have major ramifications on how future battles are fought at sea. Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.